Big blow to the TMC. The Election Commission today ruled out the alleged attack on the Chief Minister theory, which led to a massive political face-off. Holding the local police and the administration responsible for the security lapse, poll panel has suspended the Director Security, DM and SP of Purb Medinipur. Nandigram has now become the epicenter of West Bengal politics, where the Chief Minister is now campaigning on a wheelchair, challenging to take down the BJP, while the Saffron Party is leaving no stone unturned to unseat BP.
The imagery of a sitting chief minister coming to a rally on a wheelchair was bound to whip up the poll fever.
After the alleged incident that happened in Nandigram on March 10th, that eventually led to a hospitalization, also saw there had been a fracture, grave injury, quote unquote, has been put by Trinamool Congress on her ankle area. Thus, with cast on her left leg, the leg elevated, as she on the wheelchair, Mamata Banerjee is now being wheeled down this good 5 kilometer stretch as Trinamool Congress observes this day as Nandigram Divas.
But even as Mamata gets back to campaigning for her party, the debate on what transpired in Nandigram is only getting more intense. Thanks to the conclusion of the poll panel that suggests it was not a targeted attack and only a mishap.
The Special Observer's report to the Election Commission of India had been conclusive with his observation that what happened on March 10th in Nandigram involving West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee was not an attack. That's right, rejecting Mamata Banerjee's claims and claims made by Trinamool Congress as a political party that there could have been a deep-rooted quote-unquote conspiracy. The Special Observer, however, maintains that there was serious breach to the Chief Minister's security, a matter of concern, the reason why the Election Commission of India, now taking absolute cognizance, giving credence to the observation made by the Special Observer, has removed the Director Security, man responsible for Mamata Banerjee's security, the District Magistrate of East Midnapur and also the Police Super of East Midnapur. Trinamool Congress continues with their apprehension, rejecting the observations made by the Special Observer. As they say, they have got reservations about the man and that they have got very little faith.
The action taken by Election Commission is based on the report of Special Observers. The report has given BJP ammo to claim vindication and target the Trinamool Congress.
I don't think that it is anything new to see her make raise such a hue and cry on a small or whatever the injury that which was absolutely an accident, also confirmed by the Election Commission investigation and also by her own Chief Secretary and the government. So even after that, she thinks that moving around on the wheelchair is going to garner sympathy. Not at all.
I think it's very cynical, but it sort of suggests that she is on the back foot and therefore needs to manufacture sympathy for herself. And I think that's really what is sad about it, that she's created this needless controversy and hate about what was a very simple, perhaps even a non-event.
But the TMC is quick to dismiss the Election Commission conclusions as premeditated.
I think that report is not true. And there was definitely lapse of Election Commission. Because why the DG is removed a day before? Why ADG Law and Order was removed? The Special Observer, we have some reservation about him and we have given it to the Election Commission.
So you still think there was a conspiracy? You still think there was
an
attack?
Yes, there was a conspiracy, there was an attack. Otherwise, in normal situation, this can't be happening. And you cannot blame the state.
At a time when the BJP and the Trinamool Congress are locked in a fierce battle here in West Bengal ahead of the state assembly elections, the Election Commission of India today ruled out any foul play in the incident where Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee sustained critical injuries in Nandigram. The Election Commission has not only removed and suspended the Director of Security and the SP of Purb Medinipur, but also initiated action against them. The District Magistrate of Purb Medinipur has also been removed from his post. This action now triggering a fresh political fight here in West Bengal, with Trinamool Congress upping the ante against the centre and the BJP.
the EC has decided to punish three officials who they find responsible for the security lapses. But the action has not ended the bitter political fight over the incident. The big question remains, will this become the focal point of the Bengal elections? Bureau Report, Times Now.
Well, in an exclusive interview to Times Now, Amit Shah, the Union Home Minister, vowed for Ashol Pariborton in West Bengal. Amit Shah said people of Nandigram and Bengal will answer Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. Listen in.
Joining me now exclusively on Times Now is Union Home Minister Amit Shah. Sir, आप देख रहे हैं जन सैलाब यहाँ पे जो बड़ी तादाद से मौजूद है, क्या लगता है चुनाव अभी कुछ ही दिनों की बात है, क्या फल लाएगा पश्चिम बंगाल से?
निश्चित ही बंगाल में असली परिवर्तन होने जा रहा है।
और सर, चीफ मिनिस्टर ममता बनर्जी आज व्हील चेयर पे रैली किया, उन्होंने कहा है कि उनके अगेंस्ट एक डीप कॉन्स्पिरेसी हुआ है नंदीग्राम में, उनके ऊपर हमला किया गया है और तृणमूल कांग्रेस जो कह रहे हैं बीजेपी ने यह हमला करवाया, आपको क्या कहना है इसको?
देखिए, मैं इस तरह की बातों का जवाब नहीं देना चाहता। चुनाव आयोग जांच कर रहा है, उसने अपनी रिपोर्ट दी है। बंगाल की और नंदीग्राम की जनता को तय करने दीजिए।
थैंक यू सर।
मगर मैं इतना जरूर कहना चाहता हूँ, यहाँ मोदी जी के नेतृत्व में एक बड़ा परिवर्तन होने जा रहा है बंगाल के सब डायमेंशन के विकास के लिए, चहुमुखी विकास के लिए ये परिवर्तन होगा। भारत की सीमाओं की सुरक्षा के लिए परिवर्तन होगा, घुसपैठ रोकने के लिए परिवर्तन होगा, तुष्टिकरण हटाने के लिए परिवर्तन होगा, भ्रष्टाचार हटाने के लिए परिवर्तन होगा और गरीब लोग जो अच्छी जिंदगी जीना चाहते हैं, जो मोदी जी का स्वप्न है सोनार बांग्ला का, उसको साकार करने के लिए परिवर्तन।
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 1 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Election Commission has ruled out the premeditated conspiracy attack on Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee theory completely. TMC still believes it's all part of a big conspiracy. The BJP, meanwhile, wants the Election Commission to put out details of the nature and extent of injury to Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee in the public domain as well. So this controversy is far from over. Let's open this up and go across to our guests. We're joined by Dr. Nikhil Prasoon, spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party, West Bengal Unit, Kia Ghosh, journalist and political analyst, Riju Datta, spokesperson of the TMC, and Sujata Paul, political analyst. Good evening to all of you. I first want to go across to Mr. Riju Datta. Riju Datta, the Election Commission, after going through three reports, has arrived at a conclusion that it was the fault of the local police and the administration. Three officers, as you know, have been suspended. Action has been taken against them. But you still believe, and you're not willing to buy, what the Election Commission is saying about the premeditated attack or the conspiracy angle that you brought in.
See, first of all, the strength of the country or the strength of the democracy lies in the strength of the institution. But when all the state machinery and the institutions of this company, of this country are compromised, what else can you expect? It was coming. And you know, the Election Commission has taken the 10th March incident just to transfer these top police officials, which BJP has been writing for a very long time. Why did this lapse happen in the first place? Because BJP gave a letter saying that the police is canvassing for Mamata Banerjee. That's why the police was removed. So now, when there is a total breach in the security of a death category protectee, she is grievously harmed. Now the fault lies with the Election Commission. And we have reservations.
So you're saying the central observers are... So you're saying the report of the central observers is compromised. The Election Commission is compromised. Would you have agreed with the Election Commission only if it would have ruled in your favor and told the same line that yes, it was a premeditated attack on the Chief Minister?
I think the Election Commission report is a half-truth. It is not the entire story. And they cannot, even if they know in their heart that it was a conspiracy and a well-calculated attack, they cannot say it because they have to keep their top bosses happy.
Okay, Okay. Minister Prasoon, respond to that. Mr. Riju Datta says that the Election Commission has to keep its bosses happy, and that's why the report or the conclusion that the Election Commission has arrived at is half-truth. While the BJP maintains it's nothing but political drama, the TMC is saying, still sticking to the fact, or rather to its stand, that this is all part of a larger conspiracy.
Namaskar, Bande Mataram. The biggest predicament of Trinamool Congress is that they cannot afford to eat back on their words. Look, after the report which has been submitted by the observers to the Election Commission, there is no going back. All the innuendos, insinuations, accusations have been put to shreds by the observers. Now, right from the word go, they have been saying that there is a deep-rooted conspiracy. Now, this conspiracy theory has been punctured. Initially, when there was a report submitted by the chief secretary, it was found to be sketchy, ambiguous, and vague. Now, they have gone to the place, each and everything has been inquired into, they have met the people, and all the evidences are there in their at their disposal, and based on that, a comprehensive report has been submitted. Now, that is precisely what was being asked by BJP from the Election Commission. Now, BJP does not come into the picture. Main thing is, I would welcome Ms. Mamata Banerjee as she hit the campaign trail, and I wish her a speedy recovery. Having said that, these Trinamool people have been playing politics around her injury. We are not doing so. They started accusing right from the beginning that our state BJP chief, Mr. Dilip Ghosh, and even to the extent of, involving the Prime Minister, one or two stray innocuous political satire was attributed as something which has got a direct link with the whole episode. Now, such kind of bizarre accusations are indicative of the fact that they have probably run out of issues. They are trying to divert the attention of the great people of West Bengal.
Okay.
But the West Bengal people and the electorate thereof, they are intelligent enough to see through the game that they are trying to play out.
Okay. Now, we do have a political analyst as well, two political analysts, in fact, on the broadcast with us. I want to take their views as well. Sujata Paul, Mamata Banerjee, the TMC, claims that the chief minister was attacked. It is all part of a conspiracy. There were rather some eyewitness who claimed otherwise. There were a lot of videos doing the rounds as well. The Election Commission has gone through this entire process of taking into account the reports that were submitted. Post that, it has arrived at this conclusion. According to it, it does not believe that there was a conspiracy, but yes, lapses on part of the police and the administration. What is your assessment of what really is happening in West Bengal?
You know, I have seen West Bengal politics very closely. And this is a case of the pot calling the kettle black. And the reason for that is that what is different between the BJP and TMC? If the TMC is bringing in actors, is the BJP bringing in engineers and doctors? If the BJP is talking about nationalism, is the TMC talking about something else? So it is actually the BJP which is going to get a benefit due to the incumbency which is there.
Having said that, Mamata Banerjee has made a dent by getting mileage out of this injury that she has suffered. There is no doubt about it that she was injured. Whether it was a conspiracy or not, that's a different issue. But in a place like West Bengal, let me tell you that politics is all about sentiments and emotions. And that she has managed to generate empathy for herself. It's not sympathy, it's empathy.
Okay.
Because everybody is thinking like Mamata Banerjee, in the villages, if you look at the people over there. So that bent is towards her. The BJP is going to try everything under the sun. And the central observers, whatever they might be saying, there is a question mark on them. And the fact that the ADG and all the officers who've been removed are pointing fingers at them that there was something amiss. So that, will help the TMC.
Right. Kia Ghosh, what I also want to point out here is the report that was submitted by the Chief Secretary of the Election Commission, in which the Chief Secretary is very clearly saying that as far as the local police arrangement is concerned, it was not adequate. That is his observation, based on which, taking that into account as well, three officials have been suspended.
Firstly, there's something which I'd like to point out. Point number one is Mamata Banerjee. She is still the sitting chief minister of the state. She enjoys a 3-tier Z plus security. So where were the security people? Why are these local police, are they being made the scapegoats? A. B is what I wanted to point out earlier on was that Mamata Banerjee, she must have got hurt. She held a rally which we saw in the wheelchair. Everything is fine. But why is she so desperate to, encash upon this injury? Is it something that she is sensing this imminent defeat from Nandigram? Is it the reason why she wants to desperately hold this
but
as the last straw?
Party she's contesting from Nandigram. She has to campaign, isn't it?
Definitely she has to campaign, but you didn't, I believe you didn't get my point. That why is she so desperate that despite the doctors asked her to for a 48 hours arrest, why she's so desperate that she had to hold the road show today itself when we know that...
Okay, Riju Datta, respond to that. Also respond to what Sujata Paul said. Garnering
today,
empathy.
All of a sudden, she held the road show.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. So see, first of all, it is very refreshing and very acknowledging to see that even the BJP spokesperson has agreed, and everybody on this panel has agreed that she has met with a grievous harm where she has broken her leg. But let me point it out to you, a BJP MP by the name of Arjun Singh and some other BJP MPs along with him are even doubting that injury. So in the desperation to win Bengal, BJP has stooped to the lowest of the low. And talking about the eyewitnesses, you know that it has been proved on social media and everywhere that the eyewitnesses who first came and with the national channel covered, they were nothing but BJP cadres. Who knows that whether these observers have interviewed these same eyewitnesses or not?
So the irrelevant
bottom
now.
Line is, sir, let me finish and then I'll listen to you. So the bottom line is, BJP has no face against Mamata Banerjee, no agenda, no manifesto, a so popular candidate list disclosure. And lastly, their only flagship program of Hamdo Hamare Do by selling the country to some crony industrialist without doing anything for the common man has fallen flat on its face. Whereas Mamata Banerjee in the last 10 years has touched the life of the people of Bengal by the project they have done. That is the optic, that is what the election will be fought on.
All right. Dr. Prasoon, your response to that. Nobody disagrees, Riju Datta, with the fact that she is injured and she is in great pain. One can see that. The controversy is around how did that happen and now what is happening post that. That is what the controversy is all about. Dr. Prasoon wants to come in.
No, actually, the main thing is that it should be kept in mind that there is an injury. The extent of injury is required to be assessed by the doctors who are looking after her. Now, this injury is attributable to an accident which can occur. That has happened. An accident has occurred, and which is very unfortunate that it has. But they started pointing fingers at us right from the point go, right from the beginning, that we are involved in. First, they started emphasizing that this was a conspiracy, and secondly, they started accusing our leaders for that same. So this was ludicrous. Number two, the kind of politics, the cacophony around the injury is something which is being objected to by us, by BJP. They went all the way to Delhi, they met the election commission, they also emphasized that there was an attempt on her life. I mean, this is something unimaginable.
Okay,
how
so
can
Sujata,
they say,
well,
say so?
What,
now,
Dr.
there has been an official
that
investigation by...
Who is more desperate? The question is, who really is desperate then? A chief minister campaigning, of course, she's just a candidate now, but a Z+ protectee as well. She's campaigning, she gets attacked, she gets injured. The local police arrangement is questioned by the election commission. The chief secretary observes that there was lack of arrangement for the chief minister.
Yes, one thing is very clear, that the cacophony that we are talking about here is a cacophony which is going to harm the BJP to a large extent, that the BJP is noticing also, because Arjun Singh and Dilip Ghosh, the moment this injury happened, they didn't wait. They did not wait like Kailash Vijayvargiya to respond. They immediately said she's acting. And that is where they made their first mistake. Now, questioning her injury is one thing, but talking about elections and the injury is entirely another thing. When the BJP comes down to any level, talks about, Mithun Chakrabarty talking about being a cobra and stuff like that, you cannot blame the TMC for that. And this is, it's fair, because in love and war, everything is fair. So here also, everything has to be fair, because this is an election. Times are different. And if BJP is going all out, then the TMC has the right to go all out.
But in what way?
So
but in what manner and in what way is the question, Kia Ghosh? Because ultimately, if you are appealing to the people of West Bengal, and you're saying that there's an attack which has happened, there's a conspiracy that was planned to attack the chief minister. It is obvious that you're pointing fingers at the BJP. You've already taken name of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Bharatiya Janata Party says this is all just a nautanki. So the voters actually are caught between this. You're playing with their sentiments.
See, firstly, I think the big conspiracy theory has been busted. So, which is a big setback for Mamata Banerjee and her party. And secondly, the soap opera thing, which the TMC spokesperson commented upon. I believe soap opera thing, it was initiated by TMC long back in 2011 also. We saw, a series of film artists, serial artists, they were, making a beeline for the MP and election, which started from 2009 itself. So this is nothing new. The soap opera thing, now TMC is saying, they started this, I believe, in 2009. We saw the big names of Bangla cinema pouring in, all the big A-grade artists.
Setback and now, when the BJP or the BJP, I think that the voters will decide. We'll get to know that only on the 2nd of May. But Riju Datta, and I am being absolutely sensitive. Yes, the chief minister is injured. One can see her pain in those visuals that are coming in. But when she campaigns on the wheelchair, many would say she has no other options. She's the face of the TMC and the face, really from Nandigram. She has no other option but to campaign. But all of that makes for great optics.
See, I want to say, if you know the history of Mamata Banerjee, she's a fighter, she's a survivor. She has been battered, she has been bruised, she has been bombed at, she has been shot at during the left regime. The left couldn't stop her then. How can BJP stop her now? And if you talk about optics, I will give you two pictures here. One, the Bengal's daughter who has been with the grassroots, with the people of Bengal for 10 years on a wheelchair, and the tourist gang who visit Bengal during the election on a 5-star air-conditioned bus waving at people. Who do you think will more connect with the pulse of Bengal?
Well, history being the key word there. We know how what happened in Nandigram catapulted Mamata Banerjee to power in the state of West Bengal. Will history repeat itself? That's a big question.
She always repeats itself.
We'll have to see, Riju Datta. Thank you very much to Dr. Prasoon, Riju Datta, Kia Ghosh, and Sujata Paul for joining us on the broadcast.